In this video, we are going to design a sanitary system. We are going to start on the third floor. Open Basin Sink Product Database. All products in DDS-CAD are sorted by filters and subfilters on the left. In the Basin dialog, you can check the dimensions and set the mounting height. You can open the product database once again or access more options through the other tabs. After closing the dialog, the product can be dynamically inserted in the model. Use automatic rotation to position the sink perpendicular to align by pressing Ctrl key. Next, insert a toilet besides the sink. Open the toilet product database. We are going to use a wall-mounted toilet concealed installation. Automatically rotate the product by pressing Ctrl key and move the mouse cursor to a reference line. Select both products by clicking on them while holding down Ctrl key. You can copy these products with the copy function from the context menu or the shortcut Ctrl C. You can paste the copied elements also from context menu or use the Ctrl V shortcut. Insert the pasted components in the toilet room on the right. We can manually rotate them by pressing Ctrl Shift keys and then left or right mouse click. Now, zoom in the machine room. Open the water heater tank product database. Select the first tank from the tank filter. Insert the tank in the lower left corner of the room. Activate the pipe function. Since we are going to start routing the pipes from the tank, check if Use Smart Snaps is activated. When there is more than one connection available, tabs will display the connections information. Move your mouse cursor to hot water and select it with left mouse click. Here you can select another pipe material or size. Press OK to start designing the pipe route. Draw the pipe upwards halfway of the door and press left mouse button to fix the position. By pressing page down key, the pipe route direction will go downwards to the floor. To connect the pipe to the story below, click the Go to Floor button. With pipe function activated, move your cursor to the tank, select cold water. We can use a plastic material for the cold water pipe. Draw the pipe close to the hot water vertical pipe. Fix the position, then press page down and select the Go to Floor button. Next, insert a valve in the cold and hot water pipe segments. Move the mouse cursor to the desired position where the valve should be inserted. When there is more than one pipe segment at the same position, a dialog opens with the pipe segment information. Select the pipe segment you want to insert the valve in. In the valve dialog, click on the three dots button to open the valve product database. With the valve function still activated, move the mouse cursor to the same position. Now only hot water pipe segment is recognized. Zoom to the vertical pipe symbols. We are going to insert these into the vertical pipe segments. Move the mouse cursor on one of the vertical pipe symbols. At absolute height, enter the height the T will be positioned. In this case, minus 5 cm. In the T dialog, change the rotation of branch. Select the option left. Change the branch size by selecting 20 mm from the drop-down list. Deactivate the option Automatically start drawing from this T. With the T function still activated, do the same for the cold water vertical pipe segment. However, insert LSD at minus 10 cm. Now we are going to draw and connect the pipes to the wash basins. Activate the pipe function. Start to draw the pipe from the hot water T connection. Draw the pipe into the installation wall as close as possible to the internal wall, then click left mouse button to insert a band. If you make a wrong click, you can always undo it by using the backspace key. Continue drawing until the wash basin below. Create a band, then move the mouse cursor to the sink until it recognizes the hot water connection and press left mouse button. The Connect Pipes dialog gives you the available connection types. Select the vertical horizontal option. The preview is shown on the right. Connect the cold water pipe system from the T connection. Draw the pipe until it reaches the hot water pipe. To insert a band at the same position as the hot water pipe, press and hold Ctrl key. Draw the pipe until it reaches the sink below, then insert a band with the left mouse button. Move the cursor to the sink until it recognizes the cold water connection. Select the option Horizontal Vertical Distancing. The preview picture is shown on the right. Enter a distance of 5 cm. You can deactivate the pipe function by pressing Escape. Select the sink above and open the context menu by clicking on the right mouse button. Select the function Automatic Connection. Select the option Pipes in Floor inside wall. The preview image is shown on the right. Activate the camera view to check the connections. Now we are going to copy the system to the story below. Select the pipe segments by pressing and holding the Ctrl key. Next, make a selection window from the lower left corner to the upper right corner while holding down the Ctrl key. Open the context menu. Select Copy Objects by Free Reference Point. To select a reference point, make sure the function UseSnapPoints is activated. Now open the first floor model. Paste the copied elements by using the context menu or Ctrl-V, then click at the same reference point. Activate the function View Connections from above. Activate the pipe function. Start drawing the pipe from the story pointer symbols by pressing left mouse button. Press Go to Floor button. If the horizontal pipe is perfectly perpendicular to the vertical pipe, you can select the end node of the pipe and drag the pipe end onto the vertical pipe symbol. A T connection has been automatically inserted. Do the same for cold water. Check the result in 3D. Select the complete system and copy it the same way we have done before. Open the ground floor model and paste the copied elements. Now we are going to check the three stories together. Open the Important Model Manager dialog and select the Ghost Story Discipline tab. Left mouse click in the column On to activate the stories you want to ghost. Make sure you have selected the discipline Sanitary Heating at the top. You have the option to change the pen of the ghosted models. Check the results in 3D. To recreate this type of 3D visualization, please take a look at 3D basic functions video. These pipe segments are going nowhere. Click on the pipe segments below the T and delete them using the delete key. Next, select the T and open the context menu by clicking right mouse button. Select the option Exchange Band with T. You can select the reductions and move them a little further from the band using the mouse. Now we are going to design the sewer system. Activate the pipe function. Move the mouse cursor close to the lower right corner of the insulation wall, then click left mouse button. This time we will configure the pipe start. At medium group and medium drop-down list, select the options domestic water and sewer. At size drop-down list, you can select 100. At start from, select the pipe to start from floor above. Open the tab direction and position. Here we can activate and configure the fall of the sewer pipe. Check the activate fall option and enter the value in the fall field. In this case, we want to have a fall down of 1%, so a ratio of 1 to minus 100. Pass the go to floor button. Select the toilet above and open the context menu to select the toilet connection function. This toilet does not have a cold water connection, that's why this option is not available. Click on Settings tab to check the options. The fall will be calculated automatically. Go back to the Connections tab and select the option Vertical Pipe using 45 degrees connection. On the right, a preview image is shown. Select the other toilet and select the automatic connection function once again. This time, select the option Piping Floor. On the right, a preview image is shown. Now we have many pipes close to one another. We can check if there are any collisions. Click on the function Clash Detection. There is a collision. Press the button Zoom Object. Activate the 3D view to better evaluate this clash. The cold water pipe is clashing with the sewer pipe. We can try to fix this clash by dragging the cold water band a little farther to the right. Use the clash detection function once again to check whether the clash has been solved. If all is well, there should be no collision message. Go back to 2D view, because now we are going to connect the sinks to the sewer system. Select the upper wash basin above and select the automatic connection function once again. This time select the option vertical pipe connect on same height. Activate the pipe function again. Next, we are going to connect the lower wash basin, but this time manually. Move the mouse cursor to the sink until the sewer connection is highlighted and click left mouse button. Move the mouse to the sewer pipe. Select the pipe you want to connect. Press left mouse button on the option with the lowest height difference. Check the result in 3D. Next, we are going to copy only the sewer installation to the other storeys. Open the layer display. To make this step easy, we lock all layers except the one on which sewer is located. Make a selection window. We can use the function copyObject by free reference point once more as done previously. We are going to copy the selected system to both stories above. Activate the camera view. This is the 3D view of the highest story. Double-click on the vertical sewer pipe segment to open its properties. Change the start mounting height value to a lower value, for example 1.5 meter. This is the 3D view of the complete installation. We can instantly generate cross-sections of our model. Click on the section function and press the new section button. To create a section, left mouse click at the start point of the section. Verify whether use ortho mode is activated. Left mouse click at the end point of the section. Next, move your mouse to define the depth of the section and fix it with the left mouse click. When you have finished creating the sections, press the Escape key to close the function. The sections are automatically added to the DDS Explorer. Double-click to open the sections.